Next talk is from Mykola Kaliuzny from the Mykolaiv Astronomical Observatory.
In my report, I consider the latest improvement of simple interferometer network or SyncNet. The SyncNet initially had been created in Mykolaiv Astronomical Observatory as an independent radio engineering means for tracking future Ukrainian geostationary satellite orbit. The first SyncNet consisted of two stations and existed for 2 days in August 10 years ago. At the same time, in 2010 and 2013, CES, together with Fraunhofer Research Institute, carried out a European Space Agency project named PACORA, or Passive Correlation Ranger. The PACORA system is considered by ESA as a high precision alternative to active ranging radars. As it turned out, the SyncNet is a prototype of the PACORA system. Both systems are completely passive. They consist of geographically separated stations or terminals that synchronously receive payload signals of satellite TV emitted by tracked satellites. The coordinates of the satellites are determined from the known station coordinates and the measured value of time difference of arrival, or TDOA. To calculate TDOA, correlation analysis of signals emitted by satellites and received by station is used. As a result of simulation, the PACORA system of 4 stations should have a maximum error in calculating the coordinate of geostationary satellite of about 190 meters. For the SyncNet, our measurements show that the standard deviation of the TDOA is about 8.6 nanoseconds. The orbital position or orbital image of the satellite is determined using numerical model of satellite motion and measured values of TDOA obtained during 24 hours. The numerical model takes into account gravitation of the sun, moon, and non-spherical clouds. Herewith, the standard deviation of satellite's coordinate is about 200 meters. We have also shown that the networks of 3 and more stations provide close coordinate precision of about 200 meters. There are 2 SyncNet operating currently, the European and Chinese. The European SyncNet consists of 10 stations and Chinese 4 stations. Both networks have identical hardware and software. The geographical location of the station is shown on this slide. The Chinese network tracks 1 satellite, Akstar 6C, which is only one in the cell of 134 degrees of east longitude. Only until May this year, the European network tracked the orbital position of 2 satellites, Eutelsat 13B and C, located in the same cell of 13 degrees of east longitude, together with Eutelsat 13E. And this is despite the fact that the number of the network stations allows tracking 3 satellites. The network cannot track Eutelsat 13E because it emitted only the DBS2 signal, which DBS receivers of the stations cannot correctly process it. The aim of this work was to solve this problem by implementing multi-standard DBSS2 receiver Omicron to provide the tracking of satellites despite the standard of signal they emit. The composition and make characteristics of the sinking equipment are given on this slide. The main difference between SyncMed and PACORA is the use of standard digital satellite television receiver modified in terms of outputting signals from the quadrature detectors, as well as digital oscilloscopes as external agencies. Synchronization of measurement is carried out using a GPS receiver, Thunderbolt. The error of the GPS signal, pulse per second signal, is 50 nanoseconds. You should know that host stations have computers which work under Windows XP. The processing center has a more powerful computer that has 64-bit processor, 32 gigabyte memory, and 3 terabyte hard disk for saving crime and observation data. Note also that implementation of Omicron required only the installation of its software, even without the installation of SkyStar software. The existing SyncMed software allows completely automated acquiring observation data and transfer them from the station to the processing center. For further data processing and calculation of TDRA or and orbital elements, it is necessary to manually run the appropriate programs. Implementation of multi-standard receiver MEQM allows tracking the satellite Eutelsat 13. The tracking started on May 27th. The person in orbital obtained met by the same.
Nikolai, could you please turn off video? Your connection is not so good.
On repeat sums, I can continue.
Yes, please. Now it's better.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you can go ahead.
Figure in the center clearly illustrates the effect of of tracking group to three collocated satellites. It shows the 3D position of all three collocated satellites. The position for calculated in orbital elements obtained by the SyncMed on May 29, 30 this year. Distances between the satellites were in the range from 7 to 81 kilometers. That is significantly larger than the error of coordinate determination equal to 200 meters. So the European SyncMed really tracks now all three collocated satellites. I think that it can be concluded that the aim to implement multi-standard receiver on completely performed to increase consumer value. We propose to continue upgrade the hardware and software of the European SyncMed. Finally, I should express to our colleagues in Ukraine, Latvia, and Italy, of the European SyncMed. It is also worth noting the fruitful cooperation between the Shanghai and Nikolai Astronomical Observatory.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for the presentation.
Maybe just one comment from my side. So this network really international. So it's Ukraine, Latvia, Italy, and even China, and hopefully it will proceed with more interesting results, and with more stations will be involved in this collaboration.